ಹಾಕೊಂಡಿದ್ದ ಮಾಡ್ತೀನಿ Puro.
Dhalanku tom tadingina tom tachana chanchana tatvanu janoti mitta
ಮುಂಚೆನೆ ತಗೊಳ್ತೀನಿ ಅಲ್ಲಿಗೆ ಕರೆಕ್ಟ್ ಆಗಿ ತಳಾಂಗುತ್ತೋ ತಕ್ಕದ್ದು ತಕ್ಕದ್ದಿನ ಅಲ್ಲಿಗೆ
ಮುಂಡಿಸ್ತೀನಿ.
ಇಲ್ಲಾಂದ್ರೆ ನೀವು ಕಂಫರ್ಟಬಲ್ ಆಗಿ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ದಾಗ ತಗೊಳ್ತೀನಿ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ನನಗೆ ಮುಡಿಸದ. ಅದೇ ಅನಿಸ್ತಿ ತಕ್ಕೊಡಕ್ ಹೋಗ್ಬಿಟ್ಟು ಕನ್ಫ್ಯೂಷನ್ ಆಗ್ಬಿಟ್ರೆ ಅದಕ್ಕೆ
ಮಾತ್ರ
Mix 10 is for the video. Okay.
Mic check one. Can you hear me, Joshua? Mic check one. Test 1, 2, 3. Test. 1, 2. Test 1, 2. Go to my headphones. Can you hear me? Test 1. Test 2. Mic check. 1, 2. Mic check. Mic check. 1, 2, 3. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Podium. 1, 2, 3. We're good. Okay. Thank you.
Kalita
Namaste everyone. We are delighted to welcome you to the Bharatanatyam Arangetram program of Nayo, Neo and Vidya. I have with me my parents and my brother-in-law here, and we are really thankful that you are here. So first of all, I want to go ahead and thank the teacher and welcome all the musicians, teacher. I would like to also welcome all the other students, parents, and associates of Shrutilaya School of Dance, who have been part of our 10-year journey of dance with them. And I would like to welcome all the friends and family members who are here from various parts of the US, India, and all over the world. And I want to really say welcome to this program, and we would like to see that we make it a grand success. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Hari Om. Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. I would like to take this opportunity to thank Sri Girish Sharma and family to have given me this opportunity to be the MC for his wife Vidya and daughters Nayonika and Neonika's Arangetram. Before we begin, I would like to go over a few house rules. No videography or flash photography of the performance. No eating or drinking inside the auditorium. If you need to step out of the auditorium, please do so in between items. If you need to attend to your young child, please take them outside to the lobby. And most important of all, please silence your mobile devices. We would like to start this afternoon's show with an invocation song seeking the blessings of the Almighty for a very successful show. Invocation song will be sung by our vocalist for the evening, Miss Kanchinayaka. Joining her today in the ensemble is Sri S.G. Pramath Kiran on Mridangam, Vidwan Sri A.P. Krishna Prasad on flute, and Sri Pranav Dutt on rhythm pad with Guru Madhushri Sethuraman on the Nattuvangam. Please welcome the orchestra.
Thank you.
భజమానస విఘ్నేశ్వరం అనీశం. భజమానస విఘ్నేశ్వరం భజమానస విఘ్నేశ్వరం భజ పూర్వా అనిశం.
Bharatanatyam is a multidimensional art form that uniquely integrates elements of dance, music, theater, and literature into its repertoire. It originated in South India, state of Tamil Nadu. Ancient Tamil epics like Silapadikaram and old palm leaf manuscripts dating back more than 2,500 years describe this highly stylized classical art form in detail, thereby establishing its antiquity. Its purpose is not just to entertain, but uplift the spirit of both the performer and the audience. It is a true representation of India's advanced cultural heritage and civilization. As said by Bala Saraswati, Bharatanatyam is an art which consecrates the body of the dancer, who dissolves her identity in rhythm and music, makes her body an instrument, at least for the duration of the dance, for the experience and expression of the spirit. Legend has it that Bharatanatyam took its roots from the Natya Shastra, also known as the fifth Veda. Natya Shastra is a comprehensive work on the science and technique of the drama, dance and music. The Natya Shastra notes, when the world had become steeped in greed and desire, in jealousy and anger, in pleasure and pain, the Supreme One was asked by the people to create an entertainment which could be seen and heard by all, for the scriptures were not to be enjoyed by the masses. Bharatanatyam was primarily nurtured in temples of Tamil Nadu by the Devadasis, or the temple dancers, and their Natuvanars, or the dance teachers. It later made its way into the royal courts and received considerable patronage from the dynasties that ruled the region. Great emperors like Rajaraja Chola enamored this art form, adorned the temple structures with elaborate sculptures of different dance poses, most notable being the Chidambaram temple dedicated to Lord Shiva. During the British regime, Bharatanatyam lost its support and fell into a decline. It was revived and codified as we know it today in the early 19th century by the four very talented brothers of Tanjore, popularly known as the Tanjore Quartet. Early 20th century saw a further renewal of interest in this dance form among India's cultural elite, which led to the rediscovery of its beauty and significance. The name stands for Bha or Bhava or theatric expression, Ra or Raga or music, Tha or Thala or rhythm, and Natyam is dance. Even though Bharatanatyam has evolved over the years, it still maintains its quintessence and transports the audience to another world, another time when mythology intermingled with humanity. Arangetram, meaning ascending the stage, is the time-honored tradition of presenting the student as a blossoming young dancer. With that introduction, let us begin this evening's Arangetram. We will start tonight's show with Jaya Janaki in Ragamalika and Talamalika, composed by Sri Purandaradasar. Victory to Janaki's beloved, victory to the one who's praised by good people. Victory to you whose glory is infinite. Victory to the one who has good destiny. One who is born of Dasharatha, brave warrior, who killed Ravana, friend of Shiva, and who is good in conduct. The one who is Kama himself, skillful and with a collection of accomplishments. One who is second to none in valor, who is humble and as high like the lotus petal. One who enjoys the song consisting of verses of Rig Veda set to music, and one who looks after the good people. One who is capable of giving anything that is desired and is always associated with glory. One who is resplendent with brightness of both the sun and the moon and is the lord of the worlds. O great brave warrior of Raghu clan, the one who is calm as the ocean. Virtuous, the lord of moksha, and the one who lives in the city of Saket. One who is affectionate to the devotee, O Lord Rama, O Vittala of Purandara. Jaya Janaki in Ragamalika and Talamalika.
Oh,
जय जानकी गा जय साधु जन दीना जय गुमाते मां जय भाग्य दाता जय जगा जय जानकी गा जय साधु जन दीना जय गुमाते मां जय भाग्य दाता जय जय जानकी गा जय साधु जन दीना जय गुमाते मां जय भाग्य दाता जय जय
Oh,
Bharatanatyam is dynamic and energetic. It is also precise and balanced. The basic postures center the weight of the dancer and there is little use of hips or off-balance positions. Bharatanatyam has a variety of characteristic movements. Along with the rhythmic stamping of the feet, there are jumps, pirouettes, and positions where the knees contact the floor. The basic unit of dance in Bharatanatyam is the adavu. Each adavu is a combination of steps or positions with coordinated movements of the feet, legs, hands, arms, torso, head, and eyes. Adavas give Bharatanatyam its distinctive look. Many are executed in a stance with knees bent and turned outward, called the Araimandi. Moving on to our second item of the evening, Jatiswaram. Jatiswaram is a pure dance that deals with the execution of intricate steps known as jatis, set to a pattern of musical notes called swaras. The graceful body movements, devoid of any expression, follow the music so precisely that it feels like a visual representation of the music. This item will be performed as a solo by Neonika, Jatiswaram in Ragam Mohanam, set to Aditalam.
Oh,
Level, the dance has three aspects. Nritta, abstract dance movements with rhythm but without expression of a theme or emotion, also called the pure dance. Nritya, or the interpretive dance, using facial expressions, hand gestures and body movements to portray emotions and express themes. Natya, the dramatic aspect of the stage performance, including spoken dialogues and mime, to convey meaning and enact a narrative. Moving on to our third item of the repertoire, Shabdam in Ragamalika, set to Misra Chaputalam. Continuing the progress of items towards including more aspects of the dance, the third item, the Shabdam, introduces Abhinaya or expressive dance. The music includes lyrics. In Shabdam, they are in praise of a deity, a guru, or a patron, usually a king. The song may be devotional, affectionate, or narrative in theme and may describe the qualities, accomplishments, and deeds of its subject. The dancer interprets the song without much elaboration. Today's Shabdam is dedicated to Lord Ganesha, Lord Shiva, Goddess Parvati, and Lord Subramanya. Lord Ganesha is described as the remover of all obstacles. Lord Shiva is the cosmic dancer and the husband of Goddess Parvati. Goddess Parvati is a compassionate mother protecting her devotees, and Lord Subramanya is the handsome lord riding the peacock. O Lord, we surrender ourselves to you. Please bless us. Shabdam in Ragamalika said to Misra Chaputalam.
Oh,
Shani, Padme Shani, Padme Shani, Padme Shani, Padme Shani, Padme Shani,
point, the family has put together a beautiful slideshow describing the dance journey of the girls. So let's enjoy the slideshow.
लकड़ी की काठी का
As we read through the technical difficulties at this point, I would like to invite Aditya Sharma and a cousin Shrishti to join me on the podium to talk about their sister and cousin.
Hello, everyone. I'm Aditya Sharma, and first of all, can we all give a round of applause for the amazing performance? So, throughout Nayanio and my mom Vidya's journey in Bharatanatyam, they've always shown their passion for the art through daily rigorous practice. You can really see the satisfaction on their faces after completing a dance that was to their liking, like to their expectations. The past few months especially, they have worked really hard trying to perfect the story that they want to show the audience. But during their practices, they like to do this thing where they like to record themselves, perform the dance and look over it. But while they're busy recording and dancing, I like to sneak into the background and do like a weird face or like a little dance. And I don't think they know this yet, but if they go through the recordings, they'll see me. They also love to practice their dances in the weirdest places. Mom and Nainio were baking bread or something like that in the kitchen, and I walked down to see what was that really nice smell. I saw they were around the kitchen island and they were practicing their dances, so like it was kind of like a ritual. And I walked in, and you'll see this video of it later. And I was really confused when I first saw that. But I am so proud of them and their dedication to their art of Bharatanatyam, practicing every day for many hours, both together and on their own. Sometimes one would be practicing and the other would be napping, and then the other one would wake up and then go practice, and then once done practicing, they would nap. So they would like switch off Nayanio. But yeah, Nayo, Neo, and Mom, I am very proud and happy for you, and I love you guys. Thanks.
Hi, everyone. I'm Shristi, so I'm Naonia's cousin, and we came all the way from Sydney for this. First of all, what an amazing performance from Naonia and Viduate. Just a few words I wanted to say about Nayanio. So we actually didn't get a chance to see them up until last year in July. So it had been over 7 years since we had seen them. And I didn't know what to expect. So me and my sister didn't know what to expect. But honestly, they're the sweetest and the most kind cousins. And yeah, they're really sweet. And we have a lot of common interests, especially food and boba. But yeah, definitely looking forward to the 2 weeks here and spending time with them. And I wish them best of luck. And yeah, thank you.
लकड़ी की काठी काठी पे घोड़ा
जी की नाई ने हजामत जो बनाई चकबक 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 घोड़ा पहुंचा चौक में थानाई घोड़े जी की नाई ने हजामत जो बनाई दौड़ा 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 घोड़ा जो उठा के दौड़ा लकड़ी की काठी काठी पे घोड़ा घोड़े की दुम पे जो मारा है तोड़ा दौड़ा 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 घोड़ा जो उठा के दौड़ा
I hope you all enjoyed that little slideshow. Today's centerpiece is based on the 10 incarnations or avatars of Lord Vishnu and hence named Dashavataram. Kamala Jasya was composed by the legendary Sri Swadi Tirunal, the Maharaja of Kingdom of Travancore. In this beautiful piece, we will elaborate the stories behind the 10 avatarams of Mahavishnu. Taking the form of a fish, he destroys the demon Hayagriva and recovers the stolen Vedas. In another episode, when King Satyavrata was offering water to the deity, a small fish appeared in his cupped palm asking refuge. The king placed the fish in his kamandalu. Soon the fish outgrew the pot. The fish actually was Lord Vishnu, who was pleased by his kindness. At that time, Lord Vishnu appeared before him in half fish and half human form and told him that the great deluge will happen and ordered him to keep ready a gigantic boat with a pair of all animals, insects and herbs. He said he would return on the seventh day and would take them out of the Mahapralaya. As a tortoise in the second avatar, he bears the Mandara mountain on his back during the churning of the ocean. The Devas and Asuras were churning the ocean to receive the gifts from the sea. Lord Vishnu helped the Devas in two ways. First, he functioned as a base to support the Mount Mandara, which was used as an axis for churning the ocean. Secondly, he took the form of Mohini to take hold of the nectar of life. In the third avatar, in the form of a boar, he rescues Mother Earth from the terrifying demon Hiranyaksha. In the fourth avataram, by assuming the fearful form of a half man and half lion, he destroys Hiranyakashipu and blesses his ardent devotee Prahalada. As an enchanting dwarf, Vamana, he destroys the ego of King Mahabali, who was ruling all the three worlds. One day, Vamana posed as a Brahmin and went to the spot where Sukracharya and King Bali was performing a yajna. Bali welcomed the Brahmin boy and said, "How can I help you?" The Brahmin said, "I have heard a lot about you giving out alms to Brahmins. I do not want wealth or luxuries. I just want land that will cover my three steps." Bali agreed to grant him what he wanted. Suddenly, to everyone's surprise, the young Brahmin boy started growing in size. Soon he was larger than the planet Earth itself. He took a large step and put it on Earth to claim it and said, "Now the Earth is mine." Then he took a second step and put it on Amaravati, which was under Bali's control, and said, "Now Amaravati is mine." Then he said, "Bali, where should I keep my third step? Earth and heaven are already mine. Now there is no place left." Sukracharya warned Bali, "Be careful, Bali. I'm very sure this Brahmin is not an ordinary boy. He is surely Vamana, Lord Vishnu himself. Don't let him take the third step or you will have to lose everything you have." But Bali said, "Acharya, I have given him my word. I cannot go back from it." Bali then addressed Vamana and said, "As nothing else is left, you may keep your third step on my head." Hearing Bali's words, Lord Vishnu appeared in his true form and said, "I bless you, Bali. From now on, you will rule Patala Loka forever." As Parashurama, the descendant of Bhrigu Maharishi, he wielded the axe. One day, Sahasrarjuna visited the ashrama of Jamadagni, father of Parashurama, along with 1,000 of his soldiers. Jamadagni managed to give him food and shelter to all the soldiers better than his expectations. He asked Jamadagni the secret behind this. He told him that about the divine cow Kamadenu in his ashrama, because of whom there were no shortage of food there. The king asked Jamadagni to give Kamadenu to him, but he refused. Hence, Kartavira Arjuna beheaded him and took the cow forcefully. After knowing about this injustice, Lord Parashurama took the oath to get rid of all the Kshatriyas on earth. He took Rama Avatar, the best among the descendants of Manu, the successor of Raghu dynasty, the one who is indescribable with words. As Balarama, he destroyed the demon Pralamba. Taking the Krishna avataram, he herded the cows, protected his people from storms by lifting the Govardhana mountain. At the end of Kali Yuga, he will take the form of Kalki and protect mankind. Kamala Jasya is set in Ragamalika and Aditalam.
Kamala Jasya Trita Nikamara Shri Agya Griva. Yeah. Oh, yeah. Come on. Ghanava Prabhu Veera Thank you.
Another big round of applause for the beautiful performance. We'll now present Durga Lakshmi Saraswati in Ragamalika and Aditalam. This is a compilation from the works of Sri Adi Shankara. Verses have been taken from Devi Navaratna Malika Stotram in praise of Goddess Durga, bestower of power, Kanakadara Stotram in praise of Goddess Lakshmi, the bestower of prosperity, and Sharada Bhujanga Prayata Stotram in praise of Goddess Saraswati, the bestower of knowledge. It is composed in praise of all enchanting beauty and gracefulness of the great goddess who is the cause of this universe. In praise of Goddess Durga, Sri Adi Shankara says, I pray with my mind to the divine goddess whose body shines due to her wearing garland, anklets and ear ornaments, whose feet are bowed with the crown of Indra, Brahma and millions of the like, and who holds a cobra, a rope, a bow, an arrow and a gourd in her hands and wears a girdle studded with rubies, and whose hair is adorned with moon and the sun. In praise of Goddess Lakshmi, he says, to the Hari who wears supreme happiness as ornament, the Goddess Lakshmi is attracted like the black bees getting attracted to the unopened buds of the cinnamon tree. Let her, who is the goddess of all good things, grant me a glance that will bring prosperity. And in praise of Goddess Saraswati, he says, she who rides on a deer, a horse, a lion, an eagle, she who rides on the swan, the bull, and the elephant, during the 9 holy days and has a very peaceful form. And I pray that Mother Sharada, who is forever my mother. Durga Lakshmi Saraswati in Ragamalika said to Aditalam.
Hare
Sure, how many of you would have recognized, but they portrayed the deity that their name represents. Nayonika was Durga, Neonika was Lakshmi, and Vidya was Saraswati. Another big applause, please. At this point, I would like to invite their friends, Rupa and Harini, to join me at the podium to share a few words.
Hello everyone, good evening. I am Harini and I am Vidya's sister-in-law and Nayonika and Neonika's aunt. And I'm here from Sydney along with my two beautiful daughters and my enterprising husband. Wow, what a performance. It's been worth all their efforts and hard work. I take huge pride in Vidya, Nayo and Neo's for being the face of all women in achieving their dreams today, bearing all the challenges and while carrying the responsibilities in various fields. Nayonika and Neonika are very sweet, caring, soft, loving girls. But their strength and determination today has really got them to the heights of their achievement, crossing every milestone with a lot of pride. This journey is the beginning of their flight for their imagination of desires and dreams. I've known Vidya for 31 years now, and she's been a go-getter from the beginning. The word impossible does not exist in her dictionary for her. Vidya is a reservoir of energy and determination, and she drives not just herself, but the whole family forward in achieving their goals and dreams. I'll now let Rupa say a few more words about Nayanika and Nyunika and Vidya. Thank you.
Thank you, Harini. Hi, everyone. Hi, everyone. My name is Rupa, and I'm Vidya's cousin. I hope you all are enjoying this amazing performance by Vidya and my darling nieces, Nayo and Neo. This has been a much anticipated event for the whole family, and I have personally seen the hard work, you know, literally the blood, sweat, and tears that went into this, and I could not understate how proud I am of all three of them. So I want to speak specifically about Vidya today. We are cousins, but I think our relationship is unique because our lives have been so tightly intertwined since the very beginning. We were born 5 months apart and grew up just a few kilometers away in Bangalore. We went to the same school, and my earliest childhood memory is of me clinging on to her and both of us bawling our lungs out as we got dropped off to kindergarten. We continued in the same school through elementary, middle, and high schools, where the teachers wouldn't allow us to be in the same section because we'd be so chatty. So we compensated by having lunch together nearly every day, where we shared every little tidbit of our lives, from our Bollywood crushes to that evil PE teacher to our family gossip, of course. Surely, I thought our paths would diverge when we went to college, but fate would have it, we ended up in the same college again, where incidentally she met Girish, and I was one early witness to their budding love. So after college and our respective marriages, I moved to the US and Vidya was in India. We were separated by a decade or so, but then fate intervened again, and we are now reunited in Dallas, just a mile away from each other. And our kids, my son Kabir and Nayo and Neo, are just 7 weeks apart, and they're growing in close proximity to each other, much like Vidya and I did. So none of this was planned or intentional, but rather a happy coincidence and the universe's way of saying that somehow our destinies are intertwined. All this to say, I've had the privilege of knowing Vidya at a deeper and at a more intimate level. And if I had to describe Vidya as a person, I would boil it down to two things: her tenacity and her love of family. And these are two qualities that have brought her on the stage today, along with her daughters. Vidya always wanted to learn Bharatanatyam since she was a little girl, but family circumstances and lack of opportunities prevented her from pursuing it. So rather than giving up on her childhood dream and moving on with adulthood and all the trappings that come with it, she held on to the dream for decades. While she poured all her love and energy into her family, she finally found opportunity and started to practice in her 40s. It's such a cliche to say you're never too old to pursue your dreams, but really, how many of us really find the thing in us to, you know, pursue the dream that we've held on since childhood? And, you know, Vidya has done that. I know it comes from a place of deep passion for Vidya, and I cannot imagine a mother setting a better example for her kids about tenacity, about dedication, and yes, about never giving up on one's dreams. I am so freaking proud of her, and request you to join me in applauding my amazing cousin and her journey that has brought her and her daughters onto the stage. Thank you.
We would like to take a moment to felicitate our beautiful artists for this evening. On vocals, we have Ms. Kanchi Nayaka. Ms. Kanchi completed her initial Carnatic vocal training under her mother, Srimati Neela Ramanuja, and Guru Srimati Nagavalli Nagaraj and continues her advanced training as their senior disciple. She has been a recipient of several musical awards and scholarships and has performed extensively for the Tirumala Tirupati Devasthanam's organization, Shankara TV and Bharatiya Vidya Bhavan in Bangalore. Kanchi has also teaches Carnatic music to several young kids around the country and finds it extremely gratifying to witness their development as young musicians. Professionally trained in robotics and mechanical engineering, Kanchi currently works as a technical program manager in the Bay Area. On vocals, we have Ms. Kanchi Nayaka. On Mridangam, we have Sri S.G. Pramath Kiran. Pramath Kiran is a well-known percussionist from India, hails from a musical background. As a world music artist, he initially learned tabla under great tabla maestro, Pandit Udayraj Kapoor. Later, he was trained by Vidwan Anur Anantakrishna Sharma, who blessed him with the art of playing Morsing in traditional Carnatic style. Pramath Kiran is the founding member of Laya Taranga, India's top world music bands featuring Indian and world percussion. Pramath Kiran is part of other bands like Indal Yusya from Poland and Shastriya Syndicate from India. Pramath Kiran is also well known for playing several world percussions like djembe, congas and kajon. Pramath Kiran was awarded CMANA Award as the best percussionist from Bangalore and the Ananya Award, also the best percussionist from the Ananya Foundation. We have Pramath Kiran on Mridangam. On flute, we have Vidwan A.P. Krishna Prasad. Hailing from a lineage of great musicians, Vidwan A.P. Krishna Prasad is one of the leading flautists in the field of Carnatic music. Krishna Prasad trained under his father, a legendary musician, Vidwan A.V. Prakash. His skills were further nurtured by the legendary flautist Dr. N. Ramani. Influenced by other forms of music like Hindustani and Western music, and with his constant efforts, Krishna Prasad has curated a unique style of rendition in his flute, which has elevated him to his present stature in the field of music. He is a commendable composer, which gives him another dimension in the field of dance and other popular art forms. His interest for other forms of music has enlarged the spectrum of his performance from fusion to jugalbandi, from blues to jazz, with big names in those respective fields. He has quenched the thirst for good music in India and abroad, including the USA, Japan, Switzerland, and South Africa. Krishna Prasad is a trained live sound engineer as well. On flute, we have Vidwan A.P. Krishna Prasad. On rhythm pad, we have Sri Pranav Dutt. S. Pranav Dutt has been mesmerizing the audience with his immaculate style and innate creativity after learning drums under the guidance of Vidwan B.S. Sukumar and Vidwan Arun Kumar and Mridangam under the guidance of Vidwan N.G. Ravi. Further, training has continued under the able guidance of Vidwan Anur Anantakrishna Sharma. Pranav is associated with fusion, Carnatic, Hindustani, folk, rock, jazz, and other genres of music. He has performed all over India and abroad. He has also performed in many reality shows in different TV channels and has also received many recognitions and awards. On rhythm pad, we have Sri Pranav Dutt. We'll shortly continue with the rest of the performance. Our next item is Alarulu Kuriyuge in Shankarabharanam, said to Adi Talam. Alarulu Kuriyuge is a famous composition of Annamacharya. Alamailu Manga is dancing gracefully while flowers are showered on her. With the charm of a half-blossom flower, she dances behind the curtains, melting the heart of Hari. Her gait is attractive with the sound of her toe rings, and her gem-studded anklets were sparkling. She twirls and dances to bring joy to her devotees and to her beloved Lord Venkateshwara. This item will be performed as a solo by Nayonika. Alarulu Kuriyuge in Shankarabharanam, set to Adi Talam.
Alarulu kuriyaga aatakaage alarulu kuriyaga aatakaage Oh, శోభాగుణ అతి వరుమే అరతిరే మారుగుణ అరవీరి శోభాగుణ అతి వరుమే అరతిరే మారుగుణ
Next, we present Baro Krishnaya, composed by Kanakadasa, set in Ragam Mandu and Aditalam. Kanakadasa was not just a social reformer and a great composer. He was mainly a devotee of Lord Narayana. He was a disciple of Vyasaraja of Udupi. He longed to visit the Udupi Krishna temple and have a darshan of the Lord, but the narrow-minded priest would not allow him inside the temple as they considered him to be of inferior birth. Kanakadasa was distraught and expressed his anguish to Sri Krishna. Immediately, the temple wall collapsed on one side a slit appeared in the sanctum. The idol of Sri Krishna turned towards him and he was able to have a direct darshan. The wall was later reconstructed, but a small window was built there to mark the place where the Lord gave darshan to anguished devotee. This window is called Kanakanahindi, Kanaka's window. Even today, devotees have darshan of the Lord through this window before proceeding to the main entrance of the sanctum. In this particular composition, Baro Krishnaya, Kanakadasa says, "Come, Krishna, come to your devotee's house now. Come, show your face. Who is comparable to you, the supporter of the universe? You have sandals on your feet, anklets and small bells that make the sound dim-dimi worn on your ankles. You have sparkling gold rings and bangles in your hand that make the sound kinkini, kinikini. O Adikeshava, you dwell in Udupi. I, Kanaka, am an humble devotee of your feet. Please come to me." This item will be performed as a solo by Vidya.
Yeah.
We now present the final item of the evening, Thillana, in Ragam Todi, set to Aditalam. Thillana is considered the choice item of Bharatanatyam recital. Emphasizing dritta or pure steps, it is an essay of intricate footwork, graceful body movements, and sculpturesque poses. The scintillating choreography allows the dancer to abandon herself to the joy of dancing. Each passage begins with graceful body movements which give way to adava sequences executed in two or three tempos culminating in beautiful tirmanams. The movements of Thillana are joyous and expansive, giving it a very vivacious quality. Thillana was choreographed and taught by Srimati Madhushree's daughter, Shilpa Sethuraman, and will be presented as a duet by Nayonika and Neonika. Thillana will be followed by Mangalam, where we will conclude the recital with a short benediction during which the dancers perform namaskarams to God, Guru, giving thanks and invoking blessings from everyone present. Thillana followed by Mangalam.
Nadi Ranati, 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 Thank you.
Bharatanatyam, similar to any other classical dance, has evolved over decades. The bhani, or the style, is used to illustrate the technique. The overall appearance is the same, form, language, music. However, on closer inspection, each guru or region has brought special features or characteristics. Varuvur Bani, or style of Bharatanatyam, was created by Varuvur Ramaya Pillai. Varuvur Bani adds spur to the jati with 9 beats. The jatis are fast and all the 3 speeds are performed. The style also gives importance to Sollukattu, creating an energetic and a robust effect. When it comes to Abhinaya, the style is incorporated lots of storytelling. Guru Srimati Madhushri Sethuraman has trained in this Varuvur Bani under notable gurus Padma Bhushan Srimati Kamala, Kalai Mamani Sri S.K. Rajaratnam Pillai, and Padma Bhushan Kalanidhi Narayanan. Srimati Madhushri founded the Shrutilaya School of Dance. Since then, she has taught over 1,000 students and conducted over 135 Arangetrams. Srimati Madhushri has performed. Madhushri has performed around the globe. Recently, Srimati Madhushri participated in the Government of India-sponsored Bharata Samarpana Shivapadam 2022-23 tour, where 72 USA-based NRI dance and vocal gurus and students performed in historic temples in Tamil Nadu, such as the Tanjavur Periya Koval, Chidambaram Temple, Madurai Meenakshi Amman Temple, and Kashi Vishwanatha Temple. Bharata Samarpana Shivapadam tour created history with diverse dance and vocal performances in so many Indian temples of global recognition. Her contributions to dance earned her several accolades and titles such as Natya Taragai, Natya Mayuri, Natya Kala Kaumudi, and Abhinaya Bharati. Srimati Madhushri has raised funds through dance for noteworthy causes and is associated with charity through Art Foundation to choreograph and perform dance events for helping charitable organizations and creating awareness among the youth about various cultures and dance forms. May I please request Srimati Madhushri to join me at the podium and talk about her journey with the students.
Today has been a day with mixed feelings. Joy at seeing that the mother and the twins performed so beautifully. Sad that this season of my Arangetrams has actually come to an end. It has been such a pleasure this entire season to work with all the children who put in so much effort to perform to their best ability, and I've always said it is to their best ability and not to somebody else's expectation. But whether they've exceeded their expectation and whether they have worked hard to make sure that they have performed to the best of their ability is what really matters to me. And this journey with Nayo, Neo, and Vidya has been very, very interesting, because I know that Vidya always had the passion to do her Arangetram, but I don't believe that she even thought that this day was possible. I was the one who told her that believe in yourself, set a goal for yourself, and sure enough, you will be able to achieve it. I know it's easier said than done, because many of us think about what it is that we want to do, and we have so many aspirations and so many dreams, but never follow through on any of our dreams. We really need somebody who will prop us, who will guide us, or who will encourage us to go through that dream. And I'm really glad that in a small way that I made this dream happen for her. She would forget all the steps every single time that she came to class. And so I never thought that she would remember an entire sequence of steps and the number of items and the complex formations and everything that she had to remember was something that I was hoping that it would happen. But when I first started on this journey, didn't think that this day would actually happen. But I must say that, first of all, I was very persistent. But more importantly, I must say that her daughters are gems. Really, it's hard to find. Usually the mother is the one who encourages the children to pursue their dreams and to go through with whatever it is that they want to do. This time around, the daughters persisted in making the dream happen for the mother, because every time she would forget, the patience with which they dealt with the mother was just remarkable. I don't think I'm that patient with my mother. Every mother does a lot for their child or children, but children rarely ever give back to their mother. And this is something that was so beautiful for me to see, that the children encouraged and worked so hard with the mother. Mom is always a mom. And she would come to class and would say, did you drink water? Did you have something to eat? Okay, can you wipe off your sweat? Can you do this? Can you do that? All the time behind them. Never once did they frown upon her or say, Mom, can you please leave us alone? I'm sure that thought crossed in their mind 100 times. But not once did they voice that opinion that they found it annoying that she was being a mom, when she was the one who actually probably needed the most help. But when I saw the passion that Vidya has for the dance, for the art form, I'm not sure that too many children actually understand or comprehend what it actually takes to become a dancer, because it's something that is not necessarily forced upon them, but is kind of presented to them. And the moms are the ones who drive the children around everywhere and take them to classes and make sure that they practice. But that inherent desire to be a dancer is something that is very special. And when you get older, I'm realizing as you get older, that passion and that drive and that love for that art form only becomes greater. And I could see that in Vidya. Vidya is probably the one person in this entire season that I would say just had the passion to dance for herself. Not necessarily because she wanted to please the audience, but because this was her dream. And the fact that she was able to come and present it in front of every one of you has been very special for her. But I think it would have been equally special for her had she just danced to practically nobody. You know, the thing is, she just forgot who she was and she transformed and she became a dancer on stage. Whereas every other person that is up here on stage, and that includes to some extent me as well, we always want to please the audience. We want to make sure that we make the people who are watching us be happy. But when you go past that, go beyond that, and really dance because you are the dancer and you are the one that needs to be happy internally for your own sake, that is a very special feeling. And I'm sure that Vidya has experienced what it is to be that today. Now, just a short quote about a dance team. dance team is coming together is a beginning. Keeping together is progress. Working together is success. And today, as a team, they succeeded in presenting a beautiful margam in front of all of you. The fact that they worked together, there were so many times when they were ready to quit because it was a repetition and it was boring and it was something that they had to keep doing to get the synchronization. See, when one child performs the Arangetram on stage, all they have to worry about is how they present themselves to the audience. When you're together as a team, not only do you need to think about how you are presenting yourself as a dancer, but also how you come across as a team. For that, the synchronization and, you know, the fact that they're able to see one another through the corner of their eye to know exactly what it is that the other person is thinking requires a lot of practice. And I know that you saw the video where it showed where they were practicing in the kitchen while they were heating food. And I'm sure that is something that they have done many times during the last 1 year. Vidya has had a really rough year in terms of, I'm sure, her job, her knees, everything. There were so many issues that she had to deal with. But in spite of all of that, and in spite of my telling her, don't worry about food for this week. Just order food. Just get it from somewhere. Don't worry about it. She was like, no. I need to cook. I need to make this. I need to give people food. I need to feed people well. And she was having so many guests come from everywhere. But she is somebody who is remarkable. You know, the fact that she was able to cook and work and practice and put everything together in boxes so that, you know, when we came here, we knew exactly where the makeup box was, where the jewelry box was, where the hair box was. Everything was neatly labeled and, you know, done. And everybody would come and ask her. Today also, they did the same thing. And I said, can you be a dancer for just today and not a mother and not an organizer? And she was like, yeah, just one more minute. And she attended to every single call and every single question. So, needless to say that I'm really thrilled that, you know, she got to enjoy the day today. And also the kids, you know, made sure that they stayed together. They stayed and they were very focused and they were very happy. And I was very happy to see that they were really happy and enjoying themselves to present. And I know that I did not do an acrostic for the last triplets. But that was because they told me that they thought it was too difficult for me to do an acrostic on them. They had too many A's in them, in their names. And so they said, I know it's going to be really difficult. And then I realized the reason they didn't want me to write an acrostic was because they were going to write an acrostic on me. But however, today I have written an acrostic on Nayo, Neo, and Vidya individually. Nayo first. N nurtures and supports her mom, nervous of making mistakes. A, amicable nature. Y, yields to what everyone wants from her. Contrary to her name, which is Durga, she's probably the calmest one of them all. O, obeys her mother. Neo, N, nurtures and supports her mom again. I, she's independent. She knows exactly what she wants and she gives for it. Y, younger of the twins. O, obstinate, but not in a bad way. More like she knows exactly what she wants and how she needs to get things done. And you can tell her, do it this way. She'll be like, yes. But will do it her own way because she knows exactly what she wants. Vidya, V, values art and ventured to do her Arangetram after a lot of coaxing. I, idle, she is not. She's always working, either at work or cooking or practicing. D, dedicated to perform her best after having taken up this commitment of Arangetram. Y, young at heart. A, ardent about the art form, but really anxious about the steps. So now with this, I'd like to call the three of them, and I don't know once again in which order the plaques are. It's in random order, so please don't take offense. First is Neo Sharma, Neonika Sharma. Vidya. And last but not least, Nayonika Sharma.
First off, I would like to thank this entire audience for coming to both celebrate our achievement of celebrating our Arangetram and the people who came here to just in general celebrate this wonderful dance form. For me, dance has been a way for me to become more confident. Before, I used to believe that the stage is somewhere where I have to fight for myself and prove myself. Fight for myself and prove myself. But of course, with this wonderful audience and this wonderful teacher I have, I feel like this stage is more of a platform and a way for me to celebrate. Again, I would like to thank the audience for being here. Ever since we were younger, all of us have always been interested in dance, and pursuing it through this beautiful art form, Bharatanatyam, has been a tough journey, in all honesty. It's been hard on us, it's been hard on our teacher, it's been hard on our loved ones, but the end result has gotten us so much joy. And I'm so thankful to be here now, and all thanks to our teacher and my dance buddies, my mom and my sister.
Yeah, first of all, I want to thank the Almighty who's blessed us with wonderful family. Okay.
Thank you.
Okay. Yeah, I'm not very comfortable talking, so I'm just...
Got it.
Okay. Yeah, first of all, I want to thank the Almighty for giving us a chance to perform and learn this beautiful art, which is a great journey to go through. But it has been, for me, this has been the fantastic milestone which all of us have achieved. especially with the great support system I have, the wonderful kids, husband, mom, all the family members, right? So it has been a lot of fun. Many times my mom used to say, stop laughing and learn dance. Then we used to laugh loud and they said, this is what you're supposed to say. You say, right? We are supposed to smile, right? And then we used to continue dance. But there has been many, many a times I thought, okay, these girls will give up on me because they used to attend 200 times and I used to do the same mistake. Then the teacher always used to say, you'll get there, you'll get there, don't worry, okay? And this 1 year has been, I really put my focus, my heart, because I didn't want to let my teacher down, my kids down, and my family down. So I hope I did my best and you all loved it. And here are my two more support systems who have taken care of all the arrangements, right from the backdrop, along with our Arangetram dads and moms, and my son who created the lovely videos which you all saw. Without all your help, I don't think we'd have done it. And of course, the Arangetram moms, we started off with Ditya's Arangetram, really not knowing what we are going through, right? And then Varu said, it's okay, we can go through this. And the first one was all chaotic, we were trying to understand things. And then I think things became more easy once we went through Aditya's Arangetram. And Varu was like, you'll get through this, don't worry, right? Ours was the last, so I learned from all of you. Thank you, Arangetram moms and the girls, Arangetram girls who went through this 2023. And it was wonderful, okay? And of course, needless to say, in the backstage, the green room moms, the green room, all the Arangetram moms who helped us and all the volunteers who helped us out, I cannot say how thankful I am. Today it was like, I came in and I didn't know that, okay, there's lots to do, right? But it was a lot of effort from all of them. Thank you everyone in the green room there. I don't want to call out each of the names. Because I'm sure I'm going to miss, because there's so many people who helped us out here. And of course, one big thanks to us, Amama. Amama, without your comments and critics, I would not have gone through this, right? The small details, we didn't know the story. And he said, what are you doing? This is not the way to do it. This is the way you have to do. And I was like, oh my God, I didn't know this all this time, right? So thank you, Amama. Thank you very much for your help here. And can you please come on the stage? Yeah.
Thank you.
Okay, just a few more things and then y'all are free to have dinner. Go ahead. Okay, so thanks to all of like the stage crew that took care of lighting, took care of the curtains and all the backdrops. And thank you to our videographers and photographers. You guys did an amazing job, all of you. And
I also want to thank a lot of the volunteers, as well as in addition to the guru and the musicians who have been here, helped the girls practice. I also want to thank Mr. Raj Sethuraman. I also want to thank Mr. Raj Sethuraman and Chart Foundation for supporting us as we put up the show and the backdrops and everything. And if you had not heard me earlier, I wanted to make sure that thank the musicians, the family members, and friends and colleagues who have come here to share this evening with us. So next.
I just want to call Vijayashree. So Vijayashree is not only our teacher, additional teacher who guided us on what exactly has to be corrected in our steps, but she also taught us how to stretch, which I never used to do, and make sure that it was a really good show here. So I would like to call Vijayashree on the stage for a small presentation.
Thank you all, audience, and we would like you to join us for dinner and celebrations at the atrium, which is next door. We really look forward to seeing you to celebrate this evening with us. And thank you all once again for being here.
So we are also inviting you for celebrating our son's graduation this year from UT Austin. So, dinner. Yeah, please join us for the dinner at the atrium. It's just opposite this auditorium. Yeah. Thank you, everyone. Thank you.